Continuing with myriad case takeaways. Number two, statutory patentable subject exclusion. Areas of which a patent claim cannot violate doctrines of, number one, abstract idea. Number two, law of nature. And number three, natural phenomenon. Again, expanding into further details. Abstract idea, defined as ideas which do not possess any physical incarnation, for they are the things that one cannot touch, but can be mentally contemplated, felt, or envisioned in them. For example, it has been stated, former American Vice President Al Gore and International Nobel Prize laureate once asserted he invented the modern internet as we know it today, for he wrote a research paper on the subject some 40 years ago. That is an abstract idea, since no physical model was ever constructed by Al Gore in the transformative innovation of bringing an idea into a working functional model. Law of nature, which is basically a philosophical thought related to a regularly occurring or apparently inevitable phenomenon observed by human individual or a human societal group at large. This doctrine is the crust of our legal debate here in this Myriad case, whether the human genome and its derivatives are solely law of nature or can be patented by an individual upon discovery. Natural phenomenon, defined as an observed fact or situation that physically exists or occurs. Its natural aspect is that it manifests or occurs by itself without human input or intervention, such as wave tidal effects, sound oscillation, or even planetary gravity. Number three, artificial DNA can be patented, for naturally existing DNA is law of nature exclusion, thus not patentable, while artificial DNA is considered not natural, hence patent eligible, for it cannot originate or exist by itself in nature, thus require human intervention to create its transformative innovation.